Hello everyone, and welcome to Let's Play Top Gear Rally for Nintendo 64. Alright, let's do the championship. Okay, coastline sunny, and jungle sunny. Points needed to advance to next season. So I must be at least third twice. Alright. Yeah, whatever. Yes, automatic, please. Creepy. Yes, normal. Go. Choosing this path. Oh, so 3 laps and I'm just 19th. Get used to these controls. It's a bit slippery. It's like first you don't steer at all and then it hits. Let's take this shortcut. Running pretty well. Top Gear Rally is notorious for being difficult to emulate. I think Clyde 3D plugin won't work with this game. Okay, I get small drop downs in terms of frame rate, but it's running pretty good enough. You know, I used to play some computer games with a computer that was totally underpowered, so I'm used to play with less than ideal frame rates, 15 or 20 frames per second. So occasional hiccups isn't a big deal for me, and 60 frames per second, it's too much, so it's not that important. Okay, so some slowdown there. Looks like it's more when you come to certain parts of the track, it gets more heavier processing, I mean. Okay, some audio crackling. But I don't mind. Okay. Only 3 places and I'm getting enough points for the championship. interesting building there. Looks like a mosque or something. Come on. Oh no. Just like you press the steering wheel or analog pad too much and then it kicks in and you lose it. Okay, third place. That was plain. Yes, I used to have this game for Axon N64. And I really liked it. Oh no. Yeah, I see some rubber band AI there. I was never that good at video games, so maybe I unlocked something, some new stages, but I never managed to unlock everything. I think there are many special cars and hidden features that I never saw. All right, first place. So if you are wondering what emulator I'm using RetroArch Parallel N64 core, and this worked quite well. Better than Project 64 plugins, to my mind. Okay, let's continue. No, I don't need to save. I have quick save function. Let's quick save, by the way. Alright, so let's see. Yes. Maybe I should. No, this was good enough. Maybe normal. Feels much better. Okay, let's take the shortcut. You have to know these shortcuts if you want to succeed. It's not cheating. They are part of the game. It's important to use all the shortcuts that the developers made. Yes, now it feels much better than the earlier control steering wheel settings. This angle. I usually prefer car. Camera, but not many games had in-car cameras in the 90s. Nowadays it's even default angle for racing games, but before and especially during the arcade era, it was usually the outside view that was used in the game. Maybe there were two or more different outside views, but no in-car view. So this is like a compromise for that. Something that this game for me is missing is spectators. The stages, which are pretty good and have some nice backgrounds here and there, but the tracks are so empty. It looks like this is just a video game. You need a bunch of spectators to make it more realistic. I won the last round. I already have. I have 9 points now, so I need to be 6th. So yes, maybe a bit more spectators and some effects like. Waterfalls or rainbows. In the last stage there was that oh no, that last airplane developers had more time, they could have put some special effects like, I don't know, animals or flags flying or hot air balloons. Close to winning this one too, but depends on this last. Oh, where did you come from? Depends on these last turns, that muddy section. No, I overtake that car already? Or did it just spawn behind me to serve some kind of a battle purpose? Definitely obvious that this game has a rubber band AI. Alright, I don't see the leader anywhere, so I'm gonna finish second place, but... Okay, so there is a waterfall, but... looks pretty static, so... Oh, so close. Just finished second. Worries. Okay, what's my prize? Progress to the next season. Okay. Save. Thank you for watching. See you next time.